So welcome, everybody. Claudia said, you know, writing a book seems such an anxious project to do. But if you listen today and hear me out on what I have to say about writing a book and publishing your own book, you will see that it's actually a very doable thing. Why? Because you are an expert in your own field. So you actually start writing the book that you normally talk about to other people, but then you put it in paper. So I love to take you through, but first I'll introduce myself a bit more. My name is Marleen te Vanels. I started writing in 2003 and I started writing this my own autobiography. I come through a huge transformation and was so amazing that I felt the need to start writing. I was no writer, I had no experience whatsoever, but the urge to start writing my own story was so big that it kept on nagging at me, and I started writing. And at first I thought, oh, it will be just a few pages. I'm done in a few pages. But when I started, after 10 pages, it was like, gee, I'm only at the beginning. I have still so much to share. And so I went on and went on. And soon I discovered I had still so much more to tell. So then I scheduled some time and I organized that my mother came home to watch my daughter. So I had writing time. And I've been writing for several weeks on a row. And in the end, I had my finished project, Walking My Revolution. And at first you have your copy, you know, you have your basic copy, but then you have to reread and reread again and correct it here and correct it there. So in the end, in 2007, I got my own publishing deal. But as you can see, maybe noticed it already, my book is in English. I did so because someone I had to share it with was English. So actually I'm Dutch, I'm native Dutch, so really it's maybe an odd choice to do so, but I wrote in English. And I also started talking about the subjects in my book. I've been dealing with domestic violence. I'm HIV positive for over 25 years now. So really it was a touching story, and I started doing interviews. I've been featured in the magazines Linda, Marie Claire. I've been in newspapers like Trouw and many other magazines. And at one point, a publisher contacted me and said, I would like to publish your book. Well, it was a Dutch publisher, so it had to be translated to Dutch. And unfortunately, the quality of that translation was so lousy that it never got published in the end. So when in 2017, I started my own company with coaching, healing, training, daily inspiration, and writing, I also decided to start my own publishing company. So my first book that I published was Walking My Revolution, the same way as my company is also named. But while doing so, I made a mistake. I started with self-publishing and I made up in Amazon the account and I started writing down my book there. And I made a mistake with my international standard book number. So instead of publishing under my own imprint, Walking My Revolution Publishers, I ended publishing under Amazon. So the official first book I published was many years later in 2019. And this is in Dutch and daily inspiration book. And that was the first I got published. And once I started doing that, I was like, well, if I know what to do now, and published another inspiration book, I think, well, if I do it for myself, I also can help others. So I sent it out, the message in my network, and one by one people came to me, and they were still in the writing phase. So from last year, I finally started publishing also books for other people. So far, my focus with my publishing company is on inspiration, self-help, motivation, also personal development, coaching, poetry, yes, but also novels like autobiographies and true stories, true family stories. So on all these areas, I already now have published books, several books. So I started out with my first book on another imprint, and then every year one other title. And last year, it were only 3 books, but because I became ill, I had cancer and I had to fight for it really hard. But in spite of it, and right at the moment I was actually severely ill, one book and one author after another came to me with their finished books. So I did my best. I kept on working on these books so they could get published. So in the end, I succeeded to publish 3 books. And after the successful treatment, I picked up editing and all those things again. So this book's already 13 books have been published. Several ebooks have been published, and I'm working with several other authors to get the books published out next year. And there will also be translations to English. And I've already signed up authors like Judith Quinn and 2 American authors who are still not yet able to name, but their books will be translated to Dutch. So my business is expanding in line with my energy and with my health. But I've already managed to get a lot of experience in what it is with writing books, what you need to take into account if you want to start publishing yourself. So I love to share that with you today. I know for a fact that several of you also published their own books. Oh, I see someone I forgot. Yeah, I believe it was Hans. Don't forgive me if I'm wrong, but I'm lousy in names. But Monique Dekker has written her own book. Marieke Bertens. And there are other also people in the group that do coaching, book coaching, writing coaching, and translation. So within the EMN, we have several people with experience with writing books and publishing books, but I love to share my experience with you. So why should you write in the first place? Why would that be a great idea to do? Well, actually, it will really help you with attaining a certain authority. Many readers see someone who has written a book as someone who has had knowledge, who has authority, to go to person in your field. So it is a really amazing opportunity to share your knowledge and in such a way that you can really go into detail. You know, if you write a social media post, you have to keep it short. If you write a blog post, well, you could elaborate a bit more, but still, you know, you have to keep it small and you have to keep it simple. But when it comes to a book, you know, your reader will take time for you. They will take hours and hours and hours for you to get the knowledge from you, to learn from you, to be inspired by you, to help. You know, you are the person that can help them grow, to grow in business, in investments, whatever your field of expertise is. You can make a difference. And the people who are on the other side, the readers, really take their time for you. So that's the only option where you have such a great, opportunity for really getting to know your audience, of the audience to get to know you, is actually. So you can use it to share your knowledge, but also to use it in your marketing for your business. You see that many authors who have their business use their book like a freebie. You can give it away. You can combine it with other offers as a bonus. So you can say, look, I've written this book, but if you order now product X, you can get a free copy of my book. What you also see with many authors is that they use it, well, if you buy my book now, you only pay the shipping cost and you get the book for free. So it's really a way where you can attract a larger audience, so you can get leads for your business. And since most of the time books are in a price range where you don't have to pay that much, it really is an easy sale for your clients. They can get to know you, they get to trust you, you get to show yourself, you get to show your talents, your expertise. And the reader gets to know you and maybe gets inspired to work with you. So in my course, a lot of time to write your book, but then in the end, it pays back because it gives you additional opportunities to attract readers. If people get your book from a bookstore, they might pick it up and I never heard of you, but hey, I see your book. Let me see. Oh, it's interesting. I'm buying it. Or they see it on, you know, the bookstores or wherever online. You really reach a far larger audience than you might easily think of. So that's one opportunity. But you need, for those of you who are Dutch or from Belgium, you need to take into consideration one thing. There are countries like the Netherlands and Belgium that have fixed prices for books as a protection for the authors. So you can't just promote your book and say, oh, today my book is 20 and tomorrow it's 10 or next day is 30. That's not possible in the Netherlands. You have a fixed price and you can only do something with the price after your book is out for a year or in combination with other products. So if you sell a course and you add a book for free, that's possible. If you gift your book, that's possible. So if you're from an other country,
can I ask you a question about that?
Yeah.
So that's only if you put ISBN number on it, right?
No. No, that's a misunderstanding. I'll get to that later. Okay. Is that okay?
Yeah, so, because I've seen a couple of books, Dutch books that have been published. They don't have an ISBN number and they sell them out of their own store. And they are not even 7 euros.
They are then in violation of regulations in the Netherlands. If the book is in Dutch, if it's
in Dutch,
then they could be in trouble.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah. So I can do that later, but you know, so sometimes you have regulations in your country that makes you have to pay attention what is possible. So in the UK, in the United States, you can do with the prices whatever you want. But so if you're from another country than those, check your local country what the regulations are on books or certain those kind of products, because that might put some limits on your possibilities. So in reality, a book is there for a great marketing tool. So you get status, it gives you access to maybe far more people than you normally would have thought of. And you know, you really can get the attention of your readers. So it might be a very smart business step for you to take. But then I hear many people say, yeah, but I don't know, writing, that's not for me. Really, none of my authors thought of themselves as writers. They just felt the urge to start writing, the need to start writing, and they start doing so. Some took courses, some didn't. They just started writing, and when with the feedback of editors, they worked on their book to make it better and better. Of writing coaches, you know, to make it better and better, and then it became a magnificent book. That's worth reading, that really leaves you in awe, that people can't put aside because they keep on reading. So writing is something you can learn, but if you're an expert in your field and you start writing a book that is about your favorite topics in your line of work, then really it is easy to start doing so. Because if you take, you have, for instance, those books that say 12 Steps to Freedom, Financial Freedom, 10 ways to leave the past behind. You already have steps. So if you put them in, you start looking at it. Okay, this is my subject. So what are the, this is my title, the main subject. So what are the sub-subjects I want to start addressing? And you write those down. And you then start, you know, thinking, okay, so if I talk about subject A, what do I need to tell you? Take the keywords for those. And you actually already have the foundation for your chapter. And it only is a matter of time to start writing about the subject and say, okay, then I need to talk about this. Do I have this keyword? Yeah, that keyword. And you start writing. You can take in examples from your business, like business cases. If you have a practice, you can use how a client make progress, or if you are in... investments you can make, talk about a great deal you had once, or, you know, you could put in those examples as well. So that really easily fills in the pages. And you see business books like 12 Steps books, etc., already from, you know, about 80 to 100 pages. That's already enough to make a statement. And if you put that back into when you start writing your in Word or whatever, that's about 60 to 80 pages. So that's not that much. You can easily fill that up if you really are passionate about your topics. So so that is when you have a book that's like a 10-step book or 12-step book, you know, those are 10 ways to get, you can address it that way. Now, if you want to write a book about a certain topic and it's not, you know, to share your knowledge in a certain field, and it's more about expanding, like Marieke did. I told you I published Marieke's book. I just told earlier that she's written. She started writing about mirrors, how your life is full of mirrors. And she put in example after example in several fields, like relationships, parenting, children, work, your own company, how you can, what mirrors might be saying to you. So what is the mirror you're looking at, and how can you flip that mirror? So then it's really a matter of, you know, digging deeper and deeper and deeper. And when Marieke came first to me, she already had an idea of her book. But she made a mistake, like I said in the beginning, to think, you know, it's just like writing a blog post. She kept it too short. And that I noticed too often, that people think they have to keep it short. You can expand. You can say lines and lines and lines about a certain topic. So she has about over, about 19 examples in a book in several fields of life that you really can put together. So you know, you can say, oh, I have trouble today with this. You just look it up and you can work on your own personal development in that area. So a book like Marieke's book, obviously she took a lot of more time writing. And a 12-step book or those kind of books, you know, some say you can write it even in 40 hours. I've been in courses where they say you can do it in 40 hours. Some say 4 to 8 weeks. If you have structure, if you have, you know, make time in your calendar, it just takes time, you know, prioritizing your agenda. And then you can start writing. But, you know, it's not really about putting so much pressure on yourself on writing and keep on writing. Just make sure that you write a book that you yourself are proud of to read. That you say, this is the kind of book I would have loved to read about this subject. And then you make the difference. And people will notice that when they start reading, that it's written with love and not so much like, I need to finish the book, I need to finish the book. Really take your time. Because often, people think that after writing that they're done and it's ready to get published, but it's not the case. So a further advice I can give you is that if you write a book, especially if you write a 10-step book or 7 ways why you should do this, make it more about the why and the what and not so much on the how. If you have courses that go digging deep on the how, or if you have programs that go deep in on the how, just use examples that people get a sense of what they can achieve by applying it, but that they then still have to go to you to obtain the course to apply the how. So that's really another way to, you know, make your book a part of your marketing funnel so that people can get to know you, can get to know what you get to offer. And then he said, oh yeah, I love this message. And now I want to do this. And then you get, they come to you for getting to know the how to do it. Or to dive even further and to dive deeper into the information. So it really can give you all kinds of opportunities. And nowadays, now that printing is far more flexible and if you have printing on demand services, and you really can adjust your books at all times, almost all times, you often see also the opportunities of putting additional information in your book. Like I've got a book from another author, and she sends the readers to her website to get additional bonus material. You know, if you want to have this financial tracker, go follow this link and you can download it for free. And obviously, after leaving their name and email behind. So it's another way of lead generation. So you can really guide your reader through certain steps to get to you, to other projects, to other products, to other services you offer, if you make the connection between your book and your website. So it can be a really good lead magnet. Also, for someone who purchased your book elsewhere, like through the major bookstores, those people can still come to you directly if you add those kind of bonuses. So, all these options make it obviously very worthwhile to start considering writing. Some more advice for the structure, because some people ask, I want to do it, but I'm struggle with the structure. Like I said, take the main topics, make them chapters, and start writing about those, subjects, sorry. But sometimes you really are in the, thinking, yeah, I know, but I know a bit of this and a bit of this. Then just start writing, because once you start writing, you get the hang of it. You find your way of writing, your flow, your own writing style. And sometimes then after that, the structure falls in place and you start writing about this and about this. And while you go on, you suddenly notice, hey, wait a minute, I'm still lagging this. And you put it there, or you switch chapters. And during the process, it gets the structure. I've also have authors like Jose. She wrote about the afterlife and about losing a loved one and what I can do with you. And for instance, this one is about how to walk the spiritual path and all the doubts and uncertainties you come along. And those books have small chapters, one page, two pages max. And they delivered the whole bundle to me and said, well, here's my manuscript, I'm finished. And then I looked at it and thought, you know what? There is a structure in there. You see, those chapters are all about living in the afterlife, and those are all about advice for mankind on earth, and those are about how to deal with loss. So if you start looking later on, you see, hey, wait a minute, these belong together. And then if you put it in those sequence, your structure falls in place. So sometimes it just takes starting to write first before you can see the overall structure. So there's no wrong way to do it. It's just getting started and give yourself the chance to see where it will be going. And one other thing with structure, what really is important, is that you think of how it is to read a book. Sometimes I also get manuscripts and they have these huge chapters, but maybe start thinking of when you read a book and you think, oh, today I'm going to read one chapter. So if that chapter is 30 pages, now I bet you already stop at page 5 because, oh, it's way too long and I need to do this. But if the chapter is 10 pages, then you start thinking, oh, it's almost done and I want to read to the end. And, oh, I'll take some more time and it takes some more time. And you get the chance to keep your reader longer interested in you, more interested to keep on reading. And if you end your chapter with a cliffhanger to the next chapter, then sometimes it really gets difficult to put the book away. And you keep on reading. And you start think, oh, well, I skipped this. And oh, I do the dishes tomorrow and I do this, you start negotiating with yourself in order to keep on reading. So you need to think of how a reader would use your book. So in also, so not too large chapters, but also within a page, you need to have paragraphs. You know, sometimes with new writers, they don't have a sense for paragraphs. And you get a full page with all lines continuing on and on and on and no air in between. That's not going to work. So if that's not your strong point, no worries. Just keep on writing, because for those kind of situations, you have editors who can help you make that clear. But really takes a good book to get the text briefing. And another thing which you often don't see is, for instance, is that you really, if you look at the text, is that you let the text walk all the way to the end of the page. You know that it's, know that you have a lot of white space at the end. It looks more professional. Sometimes really small things, and also how to let your text work for you so that you can keep on getting the attention, that people take you seriously and keep on reading. And for keeping, keep on taking you seriously, it's also very important that you don't underestimate how your writing is done. So if you know from yourself that you're not that good in grammar, that you're not that good in spelling, that you have struggles with where verbs need to be in sentences and all those, make sure that you get an editor. And you have, when you find editors, you need to be aware of the fact that they have often different kind of packages. You have editors that just read the things and correct the most simple things, but you also have editing packages where they look at the structure of the sentence, if your chapters are logical. You know, you can get all in between. So be honest with yourself and see what's necessary so that you get a text that is as good as possible. You know, there always will be mistakes in it. You know, there will be skipped here, a thing or there. No worries. But if you make too many mistakes, that will look badly on your authority. Then people say, yeah, you might be a good coach, but if you look at your writing, you know, so don't underestimate the value of good editing. So that's really important. And you can also think of whether your book might benefit from illustrations. Sometimes it's necessary, sometimes it don't. And don't put it in for the as page fillings while they don't have any connection with you. If you're too serious, don't make funny illustrations, because if people start doing workshops with you and they like, you know, your book was funny, but if I talk with you now, you know, but you're way too serious. So make sure it is in line with who you are. And you can go elaborate on it. If you have a very, your clients are in the high paying levels, make sure you invest in the best looking book possible, because it has to reflect your audience. So if you have, like me, my audience is mostly, you know, we as ordinary people, you know, it doesn't matter who you are, as long as you're interested in developing yourself, that's okay. I'm in consumer market. So if I can come with a very deluxe edition, many might feel uncomfortable with it. But if you're a high class coach or whatever, then maybe that classy edition might be just the way to go for it. So also look very closely, who's my audience? What does that mean for how my book needs to look? Very important once more. So really, as you see, it really is very actually logical information and steps that are doable, and sometimes you just need to get some help. So after you have written your book, you need to reread it again and again, because you know, the first draft is, you think, oh yeah, I finished the book. But then if you start reading again, you start to notice that you might miss information, sentences don't go well, maybe you see, oh, I forgot this, or did you see, oh, I put in this example, but actually it's not working that well. So the second round, you start noticing all those details. And the third round, you really often see, okay, this is really good. Oh yeah, that's now better. And you start making small adjustments. So after you read it at least 3 times, then you start using an editor, unless you know that your writing is not your best quality, then it might be a good idea to start hiring a writing coach. Now, I just give advice along the way, and if you need just a small nudge, you know, then you're good with me. But for instance, Saskia, who will be talking next week about writing, she will go far deeper into these things. And she helps also people with who are dyslexic. So she really has an audience that needs a bit of a nudge more. And, you know, she helps them find their flow, find their words, find their way into it, and then they start writing. So it depends who you are, how you see yourself as writing, when you need to start asking for help. But when you get your manuscript finished and you think, yeah, this really is the good thing, really, I consider start to hire an editor to make a final check. Unless you obviously are yourself a linguist, then there is no need for it. Yeah, and then after the editing phase, then we get to the phase of actually publishing your book. So, and then you have many ways available. You know, in the old days, the only way to do so was with traditional publishers, and you had to hope to get a publishing contract, and then you could publish your book. Nowadays, you have all kinds of self-publishing services. You have the traditional book publishers, and you have mixtures like me who are in between. It's a combination of them all. So I want to take you step to step through all the options you might have for publishing and what are the benefits from each option. So first of all, you have self-publishing. You really can publish a book for free if you want to. I did so in the beginning. I used Amazon, and you have many other platforms like those that give you the option to publish your book without making any cost if you want to. Obviously, I advise you as a professional to use editing, so you have made costs. But in theory, you can publish this without doing all of those steps. Programs like Amazon give you the opportunity to make your own cover with their tools. And then, of course, it's limited in certain ways, but you know, you can make a decent cover design with it. For your inner work, you still need to, your interior of your book, you still need to do the design yourself or delegate it. But Amazon doesn't do a thing for you. So you need to have the finished product. So you need to have your book, you know, good with the interior design, that your headlines are different, that you know, that you filled out the paragraphs, that you do the designs right, that you look at how the pages end, all those kind of things. You need to be aware of, because they hardly have any check on whether the book is good enough or not to get published. International standard book numbers, someone asked the question earlier, is it really necessary? If you want to do it because you're a professional, yes, absolutely. In theory, you can publish books without it, but it also rules out getting your book into bookstores, getting your book into a store like Amazon. Amazon, if you don't have your own international standard book number, they give you one. So they make it possible for you to have that number without any costs. And that's really a benefit from that sub option. And you can also order author copies. So and just as much as you want. If you just want one, it's okay. If you want 10, it's okay. If you want 1,000, that's okay too. So really, that gives you all kind of flexibility to start publishing your book in the ways that you like. But like I said, you need to organize a lot of stuff yourself. You need to get the cover right. You need to get the interior of your book right. You need to be sure that your book is up to standard with the text, with grammar, and those kind of things. But actually, it could be a means for you to publish for free. It's as simple as that. But if you publish on Amazon and you just use their ways, you're not in other kind of bookstores. Amazon has connections with certain bookstores in their range, like Barnes & Nobles, I believe, that you can offer your book to. But if you want to be in a Dutch bookstore or on a site like, for instance, in NellisBol.com, forget it. You're not going to get there because it doesn't have, it's not going to get picked up that way. So if you wish to be available for Dutch bookstores or Belgian bookstores or other bookstores in other countries, you need to choose another option. It won't work for you. Or you have to start selling, buying your author copies and then make an account like on a site like bol.com as a business and then start selling your book also there. But it's really a lot of work and a lot of, you probably have already enough to do. But it's an option. And if for some of us like me, it was a great way to begin. The disadvantage of an option like that is that if you use only the tool of Amazon or those kind of other options that are out there, you are limited in your design, or you need to be very aware of how a design is made in order to get a different kind of cover. So you still need to get to know a lot about how to make it work. It took me hours and hours to figure out how to make it work, and you get to check your copy of the book. You need to do a lot of things yourself. So there are other options available, like publishing services. Those are companies that use printing on demand services, but more local, so not, you have more possibilities to let them do work for you. For instance, cover design, making the interior of your book look great, or they have all kinds of connections that you can get discount on editing or whatever. Services like those you can find, for instance, with Pumbo in the Netherlands, with Pumbo or Book Scout, and you have all kinds of companies. In each country, you have those kind of companies. The problem with that, once more, is that the problem is that you have to take a lot of things in account yourself again. International standard book number, you can buy, you have to pay for. If you want to be available for every bookstore in the Netherlands, you can buy, you can pay certain prices. And those things all accumulate, and the price of making a book rises with each action. So it also gives you the flexibility again to start selling your own books through your own events or your own websites. But what I did notice with those kind of parties is that the price per copy of your book really is already much higher, and it can be done differently. So there are a lot of things there to take in account. And like I said before, if you live in a country like the Netherlands or Belgium, there are these issues of fixed prices. So in advance, you really need to think well about the price you want to ask. For business books, if you want to sell your book for your business, prices like 30, 35 euros really are very common to use. It's not, you're not exceptional if you do those kind of prices. But and then it doesn't matter maybe that the price per copy is that high, but you could get better margins if you look further. So if you contact a publishing, a printing house, and then you order a lot of copies, but often they start then from 250 copies or more. So, then you have a large stock of books, and you still need to sell them. So, there are ways to influence the price per copy. but it really all has its advantages and disadvantages. And then there is obviously the option of getting a publishing contract. Now, those are not that easy to get. There are even in the Netherlands and many other countries, there are even stops on manuscripts in many publishing houses, because they already have so much information and so much interest that they have a full schedule for a long time. However, smaller companies like me do have more options, or there are companies who help other business owners to get published. They often have more possibilities. Now, for instance, if you go to a regular publisher, what you often notice is that your own revenue from a book is really very small. You get 10 to 50% of the net price of a book. So if your book is sold through the website of the publishing house, then it's for the price of the book. Say it's 20 and then minus tax, then you have your price, and then 10% of that. If they are sold through bookstores, like you know, the local bookstore, or like a site like bol.com, then you only get 10% of the price that those companies paid for. So then maybe it's 10 euros and then 10% of that. And, you know, the price you get per copy is a lot smaller. So as a business owner, and you want to use it for your marketing, then having the options of having author copies at a good price really gives you added value. And with most printing houses, if you want to order copies there, there's either no possibility or you get to pay a very high price again. So what do I offer people with my publishing business, Walking My Revolution Publishers? I actually work together with you, and I'm there to get the book together to make your book as best as possible. So you pay a starting price with me, but with that you get the cover design, if it's been in my possibilities, the interiors looked after. The only thing you have to pay besides that is the editing, if it that needs, or if you need writing coaches, that's on your own cost. But all the other things are on my cost. So at the moment, I ask 125 excluding tax. And you have your ISBN number, you have access to all the bookstores, you don't have to pay for that additional. You get, and due to the fact that you have access to all the bookstores in the Netherlands and Belgium, you also have opportunities to ask local bookstores to host you to have signing sessions. You know, you come there with your book, and they take you more seriously. If you are connected to those bookstores, then a bookstore is willing to accept you to do signing sessions, you know, to promote your book in the store. Have you come there to have a small talk or whatever, those opportunities are available for you. If you do everything yourself, if you chose the option through Amazon, then you don't have to start knocking on the doors of your local bookstore. They will refuse you. So really, that's one more item to take into consideration. Where do you want to sell your book? What do you see yourself doing? Do you see yourself in those bookstores? And really, that's a really amazing thing. With my first Dutch book, I did those signing sessions, and it was amazing. You know, you start talking to random people in the store because they look at you and see you at the desk with them, you know, with all these books. Hey, you get conversations, and either you sell your book, you can give them your business card, you can give you can talk about the courses you have, and some people walk away with buying a book and later on other services as well. And even though it might not be much, they start talking about you. You get press for your activities that you are in the bookstore. So you get in the local press if you want to, if you arrange all those kind of things, you get attention. And, you know, slowly you start expanding your brand. So that gives amazing opportunities. And I help you to get, you know, those signing sessions. If you need support, you can come to me and I give you the support. You get to have, I offer my authors 15 to 20% royalties, and some get even 25%. You can buy your own author copies. And if you want to have 10 or you want to have 1,000, they come with certain price ranges. So it's not from, you know, from 1 to 100 is the price this. And then, you know, you get your own price estimates for your books. You can buy as many as you want. You can buy it through your, you can sell it through your own websites at your events. That's all the possibility. And your books or books are sold, you know, through in the Netherlands and Belgium. So that really is amazing. So I offer the authors options to choose. Well, you know, no, Marlene, you take care of everything, or you can, no, I want to do this myself, or I want to do this myself, and I have this idea for my book, and I have that idea for my book. So what's possible, you know, we really work. But so far, my field has been, like I said, on inspiration, on motivation, on self-help, on personal development, those kind of areas. So if you have a book on finance, well, then I can't help you in that area, and normally can't help you in that area. But I love the EMN. I became a member in 2017. In 2018, I've been a member. Then I left the group, but later on during my business coaching and when I was talking to my clients, I noticed that I got so much value out of that year. So earlier this year, I came back. And since I noticed that we have each so much value and so much expertise, I have an amazing opportunity for you if you'd like to. For you, if you are a member of the IMN, especially, but I understand there are also other people might be watching. But for those of you in the IMN, I suggested with Claudia the idea of starting publishing our own books. And then those books where each author writes a chapter on a certain subject. Now, I know that you're all experts. So I can think of, you know, themes of a book, but I don't know if everybody wants to write, but maybe start writing with just one chapter and making together a book on a certain subject, like for instance, on coaching or on investments or on health and well-being. I really figured out that we can make at least 3 books, and we combine 10 to 12 IMN members who want to write on each title. Then you can force each other, you know, because in the end, we have a book to promote. You can say, I'm an author for those of you who are not yet an author. And people read the book, and you know, you promoted your book, and they said, oh, yeah, I know you. And then they read the chapter of another, and they say, oh, but people get interested in the other authors as well. So it's an amazing opportunity to start writing, you know, in a simple way, to start discovering your own voice, to start combining knowledge, and to start making a difference with you as an expert, but also together as IMN members. We have so much to offer. We have so much value. So I would love to hear from you all if you might be interested in doing such a thing. And of course, then I love to coordinate it. I love to make it possible that we get from idea to book and make it possible to publish it. Even it can be either in Dutch, it can be in English, so that we go international. All options are available. So don't let yourself be held back, but yeah, I love to, but my English isn't good. Maybe we can do several things, but I'd like to know how much of you are interested in that. So if you are interested, please contact me. I am an IMN member, so you can find me in the app Claudia was talking about. We have a WhatsApp group, you can find me there. I am on Facebook, Marlene te Vaanholt. Or Walking My Revolution, that's my page. I have a business page, Walking My Revolution. Walking My Revolution Publishers on Facebook. I'm on LinkedIn, Instagram. You can find me, I'm sure. So this is what I had to share with you. And I've missed if there are any questions, because I'm just talking. But I was thinking, I want to share with you, and I hope that you noticed today, well, that writing as such might not be such you know, so, such a thing to be anxious about. It might be doable because you talk about something you love and you start, instead of talking about it, you start writing it. And that for publishing, you have the choice if you want to go do it, keep everything in control yourself, or did you want to delegate and get support and where you can find your support. That was the message what I wanted to give you today, that there are several options, and for each of us, there's an option available that will work for you. So
it's amazing. It's really amazing that you give us the opportunity that we can bring our books into the Dutch bookstores, you know?
Yeah.
Because I always thought that's not possible for, it's only for the big ones possible. Yeah. So you really organize that we can be there. That's amazing.
Yeah. Well, actually, anyone can get into the local bookstores, you know, but it means that you have it for the Netherlands and Belgium. It means that you need to have a subscription on CB. That's a central bookstore. That's a really large depot with thousands and thousands and thousands of books. They really automated it recently, that you know, they have automated carts, they pick up a book and then go to shipping. So all those bookstores in the Netherlands that offer their books online actually get the data from that center. So if you're not a member of Central Bookstore, then you don't get on all those websites and all those bookstores. You're not available for them. But getting a subscription costs money. So I pay about 50 euros a month, about 600 euros a year, just to be able to have entrance to the bookstores. And then I didn't sell a copy yet. So for each copy sold, you know, you pay another fee and those kind of things. So it takes an investment that if you just have one book, it often isn't, a good business move. So if you have connection with, you know, like a publishing house or like a publishing company like me, then you have that connection and it doesn't cost you a thing. So yeah, Claudia.
Yeah, thank you. And and as you mentioned, it's a wonderful idea of you that you are collecting stories of our members and combine it together in one or two bundles of books, you know, expressing the people of the IMN. It's amazing, you know, because we have the YouTube now where people can express themselves. We are within our group, and the book will be another possibility that people come out with a story and we can show how wonderful people we have at the IMN. Thank you for that.
Yeah, and obviously, I didn't know if I just stressed that enough yet. You know, it's obviously a great way to, a marketing tool for yourself, but also for the IMN as a business club that might be beneficial, so that we might be able to attract more members as a result of it. So more people get interested in the IMN, so the IMN also gets more valuable for each of us. So it was a two-way stream. So it's not just for us as a member, but also to promote the IMN more and to, you know, start building.
Yeah.
So are there more questions?
Are there more questions? But you said you would check for me because I with my phone, my camera on my laptop is really lousy. So you always use the phone.
Yeah. Whether... Mm-hmm. I will see. So Els was asking if you should not be coached during writing. She can tell about that, what you was asking. Ava had to leave. And Aldrin likes to contribute to this. And Wendy had to leave to another meeting. But yes, and Hans too. So yes, please, people, tell about what your question is and let us know.
Okay. Yeah, like with the coaching, you know, it's an option. Certain people approached me earlier this year because they wanted to have a business book about their coaching system. But they really said, you know, I'm not a writer. So I connected them with a writing coach. So they could start writing and they could, you know, say, oh, I've got this finished. Can you please check it out? And she helps them transform their words from the head to paper. So, you know, some people are more specialized in that. So it might help if you really struggle with that. But it depends, because they had really a big system that they needed to work out. And there was a lot of chaos in their mind. And then writing coach can help you to get that structure and to keep it to those kind of information you love to really need to share. Because sometimes, I don't know, I can talk about for hours about this too, but sometimes you need to narrow it down for the purpose of your book. And especially on that level, people have difficulties. So I know writing coaches, Saskia will be talking about it too the next time on how to write and how to get more structure. So you might get some more advice there as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but that is entering in this coaching question, because coaching can be everything. Yeah, that's we agree on that. Only if you, I'm already writing a book and I'm very well doing with words, so that's not the issue. But to, I don't know when to end. I don't know, you know, you need some help to get it, some help also with decision making in the process, during the pure process. Otherwise, I will write, for instance, me, personally, I will write an eternal book and it will never end, because it's never good enough or never thing. So you have to have somebody who helps you to get the decisions done, who gets the, and sometimes, of course, it's also nice to if he or she reads it and then says, okay, this is the right direction, this is in the theme, or that you also can have this feeling of partnership in crime, so to say, because otherwise it's, for me at least, I know I'm writing and I'm writing, I say, when do I finish this book?
Well, that's what writing coaches are for, you know. You have them in different kinds also, but there are writing coaches also there that help you put that structure there, that look with you to how you build up your information, if that's done well enough. There are options for that as well. And that's what a writing coach is for often. Yeah. So okay. You can get someone, yeah.
Okay.
And with the authors I had, you know, I read sometimes and they come to me with their first drafts. I read about a chapter or two in the beginning, and then I'll see, okay, I see that you've got this kind of style. I give them pointers if it's necessary. And some just is already good enough, you know. You don't have to do much more than that. And obviously, before a book gets to the bookstores, each book is checked. I always read it, but I read it in the end, in the phase where it needs to be edited to go to print. So I would also do the design of the book, etc. So I can do those things, combine those things together, and then I give even more feedback. And I notice things, oh, this isn't good or that, and we get to that point as well. But if you know that's your weak point, you know, it's the end of the thing, and keep on writing, then it also often comes because you didn't get your subject straight enough. That you want to, you have it too large and you could narrow it down. Sometimes people think, well, I want to write about this, and this in my book. But actually that naming several subjects that might be the content for four different books. I had an author earlier, a couple of months ago. He said, yeah, I want to do this. He said, those are several books, you know, different kind of audience. Sometimes it helps to look at your target audience, which group does need to know this, and then for another group you write it just a bit different, and then you say for you, she had about sexuality, for instance, so she had books that were designed for those that still wanted to have children, for those in the menopause, and you know, different stages of life, so different audiences, so she could really you make it several books. So if you keep on going on, going on, then obviously you don't have also clear what you want to write about. If you get that structure, okay, I want to write about this subject, so I need to tell about this, this, and this, and what are the keywords, and that you then know, okay, I gotta have a chapter that is no longer than 10 pages, for instance, then you already have the framework to keep yourself short. So I don't need to, and you really have to work out, okay, what do I need to tell? This is really important of, is this something I love to elaborate on? And is that, and you can do that in, for instance, your blog posts, or you can start doing a podcast about those subjects. Then you have your book for your overall view. And then, for instance, with podcasts or videos or blogs, you can start expanding on some certain subjects more. So I feel more with you that you have a lot, you can see my hands go, a lot of content going. And you can start small and use the book as your framework, your foundation. And you can take certain subjects out of it to expand on in other areas. So in other social, other media formats.
Mm-hmm.
So keep that in mind as well, so that you can have, you don't just have your, book, you have your courses, you have your coaching or whatever you have, that you can elaborate more on it.
Yeah, we can maybe would not to dive too deep. I make short stories, but I make thousands of those stories. Let's have it after the meeting. Yeah, that's what I want.
Just contact me. We can have a call.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I wanted to say. Sorry.
Cool. Justice has a question.
Okay. Hi, Justice. I wanted to speak to him, but.
Okay, I'm gonna mute myself. No, I just wanted to add to this conversation about when we're in like the flow of just keeping on writing. And something I would like to add is consider the benefit of the fact that you're just producing words nonstop. You know, as Marlene pointed out, you're probably writing multiple books at the same time. And you want to consider, okay, well, if you're in the stage of writing and just endlessly producing, like you've got the train going, maybe that's worth more than already trying to narrow things down. Maybe you want to write first until the pool is dry and then start workshopping it into something else. I just wanted to provide a different angle. But I think Marlene is right. Like if you're really in the habit of just producing words and just like going into all different sorts of topics, you really want to might think about expanding what it is you're going to produce. For instance, podcasts, as well as writing multiple books or producing, as you said yourself.
I think the connection is a bit shady right now.
That's what I would like to add.
Yeah. Okay. Your connection got lost a bit. Everyone else who is still watching or watching the recording later on, Justice is also someone who is working with language and does also do translations, works with English. So that's what I mentioned, that the Ironman has many experts in the field also for publishing and writing. So if you think of writing your book, for instance, in Dutch, or if you have a Dutch book, you can also think of translating it to English. If you already published your book in English and you think, well, it might be also interesting for the Dutch market, and then you can also think about having it translated to Dutch. So don't limit yourself by the language. If you're more fluent in one language, if you think it's also a good opportunity for another language, then those options are available as well. That's why I'm translating at the moment books to English and books to Dutch, because they're an option. And yeah, for the moment, I do all those things myself. Yeah.